Yeah, let's get into it.
And we're live in 5, 4, 3. Go time.
Welcome back to episode 5 of Doomtree TV.
Doomtree TV week 5.
We are your hosts, Paper Tiger, Cecil Otter, whoever you may be. I'm Lady Beak. Cece, stoked to have you on here. This completes the circle of life.
I know. I was so excited when you asked me.
How are you doing, man?
I'm doing good, man. I'm feeling pretty dang good. Kind of just working out at the studio a bunch, so I'm feeling extremely grateful. Like, me and Brady kind of got it going just in time to where I can go over there and be sterile.
Yeah,
and awesome. Work on beats and just work on whatever out there. So it's been sweet.
Amazing.
That's great.
I'm digging it.
You've been cooking up a storm too, right?
Yeah. Oh yeah. We cook every single night or a few times a day sometimes. So yeah.
I've been surprised at how little I knew how to cook before this happened, before COVID. Yeah. And now it's not like I'm learning a ton. I'm not making ratatouille by any means, but I am
you're watching it. You're watching ratatouille.
You know, I'm watching a lot of Ratatouille, so I feel like I'm picking up on something. It's been cool. Like, even just learning how to, grill chicken breasts, or, how much, time to cook things, or how to, cook down vegetables. Sweet. Yeah. Cooking rocks, guys.
Yeah. I still can't cook anything at all. it's just not a skill I'm ever going to have. I'm really, really bad at it. So much worse than you think. I can't do two things at once in the kitchen, so
very hard.
If it requires doing two different things at the same time, forget it. I'm out. One of them will burn for sure.
What about two turntables?
I will burn those to the ground. But it's like the rice I tried to make. It's just bad.
Yeah.
Rice.
What do they call it when all the shit has to be done at the exact same time? Is there a cooking term for that?
It has to be done at the same time.
It's I'll be doing stuff and prepping and washing and cutting, and then all of a sudden it's 7 pots need to be mixed up at once for the final thing.
Oh,
and that's probably a really cool French name for it.
I thought you were talking like mise en place.
See?
That sounds right.
Yeah. That's what I'm thinking of.
That's the starting of cooking. So you have everything organized. You have all your whatever ingredients are all set to go. Like, your onions are chopped. Everything's ready in separate bowls. So it's just organized.
That is what I'm into. I just struggle with the last minute. Everything's on fire part.
It gives me so much anxiety. I just cannot do it. I never get the timing right. And I'm just always worried trying to get something going. It's horrible. It never tastes good at all. Horrible.
Well, come on.
We're going to get there. Cece is going to teach us. We're going to get there.
I'm okay with not knowing how to cook. I just think that's not going to be something I'm ever going to do, and that's fine. I just think if you're that bad at it, it's okay. It's all right. That's not going to be something you do. That's fine.
I would say that you live in a city that's good for that, right? You live in New York City. You don't have to cook.
You don't have to do anything except for look good. And talk about what
you do every day, babe. Stay in, day out.
The daily.
Looking good. You are looking good. Well, cheers, guys, to episode 5. No one ever expected this.
5 weeks strong.
Let's get into it. Let's jump in.
Yeah. That's what this 20 years has been leading up to.
All that with 2 glow sticks?
When the fizz is to the wall, be sure it's tonight. Let me take you to the movie, shawty.
I was gonna be busy all day. I had to drop off some guns at Jimmy's to match some silencers he had gotten. I had to pick up my brother at the hospital and drive him back to the house for dinner that night. And then I had to pick up some new Pittsburgh stuff for Lois to fly down to some customers I had near Atlanta. Right away, I knew he didn't want them. I knew I was gonna get stuck for the money. I only bought the damn guns because he wanted them, and now he didn't want them.
What the fuck are these things? They don't fit. What's the matter with you? What do you want me to pay for this shit? I'm not paying for it.
I didn't say a thing. Jimmy was so pissed off, he didn't even say goodbye.
Stop with those fucking drugs. They're making your mind into mush. You hear me?
Take them back.
Now, I knew my Pittsburgh guys always wanted guns, and since I was going to see them later in the afternoon to pick up a delivery, I was pretty sure I'd get my money back.
Flipping the beat with a spatula, rubbing the feet of my Angela. Two big hands like tarantula, hair like Pacino. Screaming Attica, abracadabra, Danza knows magica, Angela, Samantha, and Mona know thatica.
There's more.
Wait a second. Have you seen him on Netflix?
No, but I've seen him on Broadway.
Oh, no.
This armed with tools.
Yes.
Going out and hitting the street.
Art doesn't have to be a canvas. Art is what you make it on the surface. On any service you choose. And clearly this is the perfect representation of that.
Yeah,
I like
it's
how,
like...
I'll go for our papers.
I was just going to say, like, it, your interpretation of the art is part of the art. You know what I'm saying? It's like, there's a lot going on. There's a lot of ways to read this. It's
I
all
like
combined.
I like that it is wearing, like a 25-pound fanny pack somehow. It just seems very large. I also dig how tight the grip is on the chalk. It's like you can take a lot away from me, but you can't take my art. You can't take my spirit. Lock my body, can't trap my mind, I believe. Am I right about that, Sims?
Better die in Norris than live dormant. That's how we on it.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's exactly right.
Well, what can I say about this? I love the perseverance through it. Pain and injury is what this is clearly providing to me. There's a little bit of grass on one of these chalk things. I mean, I've been down in the dirt, but I came back up to do this arc. I got a bandage on my other hand.
That's right.
I'm still holding on.
That's right.
10 out of 10, I'd say.
This chalk
10 out of 10. I like that the zipper is kind of halfway down. It just says, like, I'm cool. I'm not sweating it.
No, fine. That ain't no off-brand. That's a YKK zipper, too.
That's YKK, baby.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, that's top quality.
Clearly, we're looking at a young success, you know.
That's the best zipper you're going to get on a garment.
A child who's already put in their 10,000 hours, so I'm not worried about this child.
Oh, yeah, they're making jeans.
Alright, get a vibe for the click, click, drink it slow, let me sink the flows now. And I'm on my toes now. Ever since this crew got a bit heated, we lit that match and we burning, the fire grows now. And I think that shows how hard, drinking cinder hard, nail hard. We want it, just a little piece of the comet. So I promise, want it, become it, learn how to stomach the plummet when it comes.
When it comes,
vision is getting it, with it, I go with it. So vivid, so vicious in it. My heart's like, my soul's different. I beat back my depression with both fists. And I run digits, numbers up and down, fucking up accounts. If they're what amounts, but I'm okay, okay. Heart pump like an 808. I cannot fade, look at the state of
it. Then I know this monster who wears the heads of 100 fathers. Then as the thunder kisses waterworks, night stalker walking there with all the offers. There's a bit of this monster who wears the heads of 100 fathers. And as the thunder kisses waterworks, man,
we ain't homies and she saying,
Mike, why can't we be friends?
And I'm saying, quit playing. Underground rappers are not that dope. Mainstream rappers don't go clap, they go broke. Swagger pro classic, gag on quid pro quo. Status quo static, back to quid pro quo. You are.
It's not vengeance, and it's not bloodlust. Justice is just a rule of law. So hold down the magician.
Damn it, we here at Big Silky feel that you deserve the best of web-based entertainment. In these undocumented, unparalleled, unseasoned times, we need each other to get through this. Because, frankly, shit is wild crazy. And then it's boring at the same time. So a very silky show is here for you. Young Silky, OG Silky, someone, Angel Davenport, a very silky show. Catch us Sundays on YouTube. Peace.
Marsh, welcome to Doomtree TV. Steve Marsh, host of How Did It Get So Late on MSP Mag, on all of the streamers and social medias.
Yeah.
Writer extraordinaire, controversial figure, incendiary public figure.
That magazine was it was so good, it didn't even feel like an airline magazine at times. You know what I mean? Like, right. You know, I got to interview Kermit the Frog because of that fucking thing.
Yeah.
Like, I got to interview, it was 10 years, I think it was like maybe 9 years ago that I got to interview Jay-Z because of Delta Sky Magazine. And that interview got me GQ stories, you know what I mean? It got me Grantland stories. It was such a great gig. Now it's just gone just like that, you know? So I covered the World Cup for USA Today magazine, but I covered the World Cup for USA Today because I was in Rio doing a soccer story 6 months before that, you know, like for Delta Sky.
We got to go to Peru together. I got to be your photographer in Peru, and we did a ton of ayahuasca in the jungle.
Because Sting was on the cover of the mind-body issue.
Exactly. You know?
That, like, we got to go to fucking Iquitos and drink ayahuasca tea and trip out for 10 days because of the largesse of Delta Sky magazine.
What I'm doing, what we doing, what they doing, what they doing, what they doing.
Steady a disgrace, what's the matter, you? Mama told me there'd be days like today when you wanna smash every third face in the pavement, but don't. Gotta be better than expected forever, don't neglect what you rep, don't forget shit is forefront. Each day pivotal, the weak stay physical, we meet these rituals.
Do what I do when I can't lose. Too true, too many ready to fall through. Just like you, do what you do when you can't lose. Keep true, just do what you do, do what you do. Keep do what I do when I can't lose. Too many ready to fall through. Just like you, so do what you do when you can't lose. Keep true, just do what you do, do what you do.
It's a few degrees better than something worth leaving. Though hardly a reason for me to believe in. Nation state, gender bait, race bait, self hate, speed date, capitalism in its late stage. So much work to keep my head straight. Read tons, lift tons, self-medicate. Get the fuck up on my feels, for reals. Keep the key leaving, even if the eye poked out of ideal.
It's so easy to amaze when they don't expect standards or think you can behave. It's pretty easy to impress when someone tells them you're not worth the 40 hours of the check. Jeez, I'm not articulate, I'm awesome. Been running circles around your intellect since I arrived. But I'm to be approached with caution, and maybe that's why all this fire sits behind the eyes.
Do what I do when I can't lose. Too true, too many ready to fall through. Just like you said, do what you do when you can't lose. Keep true, just do what you do, do what you do. Keep do what I do when I can't lose. Too true, too many ready to fall through. Just like you said, do what you do when you can't lose. Keep true, just do what you do, do what you do. Keep true.
but time don't stay or fetch. Crime kills and I'm in like every sketch. Blind feels from minds miseducated. Hard to walk a line when they lives so medicated.
Quickly realizing idiocracy is a documentary. G to B potentially an overreach. I guess it's not Callipolis, essentially I'm alien, or maybe this planet's all Greek. It's not Plato, it's Plato. That is no game of tomato, tomato. Jump the Sharknado, enough to parlay. If you cut the hard angle or get ate whole by what you hate most. Looking at my cell phone, feeling real shell-shocked. Beating myself up, added up, add a bot. Feeling real distant, the fire in which I stew. Colder than a witch's brew, still do what it do.
Do what I do when I can't lose. Too true, too many ready to fall through. Just like you said, do what you do when you can't lose. Keep true, just do what you do, do what you do. Keep do what I do when I can't lose. Too true, too many ready to fall through. Just like you said, do what you do when you can't lose. Keep true, just do what you do, do what you do. Keep true.
Welcome back to the middle part of Doomtree TV episode 5.
The middle part.
Technical term. Technical term. You got Paper Tiger, Cecilotter, Laserbeak from Doomtree, live via Zoom. How, you're my beat guys, you're my beat makers. How's it been? Like, I feel like, in a way, quarantine is kind of tailored to producers because we're already like basement dwellers to begin with, or yeah, whatever.
Right. Indoor kids, for sure.
How's it been for you, Cece?
It's been good. I mean, like, kind of go back and forth where like I can always find something else to do other than make a beat. but now with the studio and stuff, it's been great. I've just been learning like three different things at once. So I'm becoming an Ableton guy as far as starting with production.
Yeah.
But a month ago, I was starting as a machine guy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I'm learning machine, and I got that, like, I feel really comfortable with machine now. And then getting to feel really comfortable with Ableton. And, but then really just learning the ins and outs of like a studio and like patch bays and stuff like that.
So yeah, you're getting the full on, you're going through like a crash course in,
yeah,
production and engineering.
Yeah, and it's stuff that I like slowly been moving towards for a long time, and I got like some, you know, preamps, and now I have like a bunch of synths set up through MIDI, where I can just like whatever MIDI I want to play in the computer, I have like four keyboards that I can run it through.
Just pop in.
Just pop in and record, and then I don't know, compressors and all sorts of other stuff, and making templates and stuff that can get overwhelming, but once you start like putting a beat through those templates that you're working on, it just sounds, yeah, it's super awesome. Rewarding. But so yeah, and like you were saying, I was already like pretty much an introverted person, so this isn't that new to me. Just staying home
all the time. Like, I just have to stay in this room for a really long time. I can do that already.
Yeah.
I had this morning, I went in to plug my MPC Renaissance, which is what I make all my beats on, and the USB thing finally like snapped. I don't know what the hell. My kids had been like jumping on it pretty consistently, so it was time. It was completely dead. But in a silver lining, I threw out an SOS on Twitter, and social media heard my frantic calls, and somebody 10 minutes away from me was like, I've got one that I'm not using for the next couple weeks, and I just like rolled over, we social distanced, put it on the sidewalk. I picked it up.
Sweet.
At my house now, I just finished a beat. So shout out to my man Ben for loaning me his MPC.
Thanks, Ben.
I love Ben.
I've always loved Ben.
Yeah, yeah.
Most Bens are great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How about you, Ben? You got your keyboard right there. I feel like you might be making something as we speak.
I certainly could. But I've been kind of in the same boat as Cease. I've kind of like, I have been trying to set aside time to focus and write new things, and I've just been a little distracted and kind of not in the right space for it. So I'll definitely sit down and like try some stuff, and I've made some not good stuff and a few things that I kind of like. But I've actually been spending a lot more time kind of learning more about certain pieces of gear, and I'm trying to learn Ableton a little bit too, also because I'm nice. I want to be done Pro Tools forever. I'm just like I'm just so done with it.
Yeah,
just kind of like trying to like learn some things. For some reason, learning is like a little more distracting to me right now. So
totally. No, 100%. I think that's what a lot of people I feel like are using this time for. I was talking to Dessa, I feel like, and she was saying, she was like truly curious if any artists are feeling creative in this moment. And I think it's really difficult to be like, to just turn it on just because you have the time or you're supposed
right.
to. I can't imagine what it's like for someone that has to write words like yourself, Cease. Like for me, production is like a cool escape because I can be feeling any type of way and the music will kind of do the talking. But to sit down and have to like say some poetic things right now would be really difficult, I feel like.
Right. Yeah, I've been writing a little bit and like freestyling and stuff and it's been good, but I feel like the best thing that I've done so far is maybe channel Tony Danza and some country guys. So making some weird old songs.
You will see Tony Danza.
What's that? Yeah.
You'll see Tony Danza on episode 5.
Yeah, he'll be around. It's Tony Danza, and then we did a deep fake with my face over his.
Oh my god!
It took me years. I don't know, like 3 years to get that going. But
perfect.
But like working with Coulter and Solid Gold stuff has been kind of nice.
Yeah.
Because it's just like it's not hip hop, which is good and bad. Like, but it's just nice, like a little departure, and then you're dealing with someone who can like write lyrics on the fly so quickly and they just sound beautiful, and then it's just on me to try to make the rest of the beat sound good and bring in some bass lines from Adam and stuff like that. So that's been going really good, but like making beats from scratch and stuff like that have been like just make a few loops, then walk away, make a few loops of something else, walk away. So I got a lot of starts. I don't have any finishes right now.
It's hard because there's so much. There's this built-in thing where there's extra time and it feels like you should be being so productive with all this extra time. And it's just not happening right now.
Yeah, totally.
Right, right.
What has been fun for me is learning how to use iMovie, even like 0.5% of iMovie to like stupid bits. Like that has been, I've said it before, but it feels like when Doomtree first started and we were all kind of learning how to make beats from one another. Like the same way that that POS took me to a record store and shot and like taught me how to chop samples. Sims was on a Zoom with me 2 weeks ago teaching me how to like edit in iMovie my little like iPhone clip or whatever. And I was like, wow, this is kind of full circle.
Yeah.
And it feels cool to like try a different medium. So whatever. That's cool.
Yeah.
That's why we started a TV studio.
All right. Well, we're done with the middle section.
Let's keep it going.
Let's keep it rolling. Let's see some more of these clips, some more iMovie stuff, and we'll see you in a little bit.
Yup. All right, it's a very short episode. Here's a very short song. See you next week.
Simsy Fixie, episode 4, episode 4000, Revenge of the Insane Hair Week. It's great to be back on Doomtree TV, live and direct, sponsored by Doomtree Patreons. That is you. Okay, weird week. Another week on quarantine. You know, quarantine's been good to the kid, obviously, as you can see. You know, what can I say? This week is sponsored by this cello that's sitting here. This week is also sponsored by this photo of me as a young tennis legend. I was playing tennis with MK Larada in my Laserbeak t-shirt. You know, a young Roger Federer, a young Richie Tenenbaum. A lot of requests this week. Thank you guys so much for all the mail. You know, it's amazing every week. There's just too much to do. So I try to fit a little bit in where I can. One of the main focuses that I'm trying to do here is make sure that everyone has access to be able to kind of beautify their space and do it in a simple way. Try to do really time-effective, cost-effective measures, whether that's your house or your apartment. I don't really want to make a separation between if you own it or if you don't own it, because a lot of this stuff is easy and cheap and you can do it and it's going to improve your space. We're going to replace a very, very insanely crappy sink faucet with a new sink faucet. Okay, for all you sticklers out there, I'm not just going to remove one and put it back on. Even though technically the process is exactly the same, a lot of you guys are, you know, purists and you need it. You need to see it be different. So this week, you're in luck. It's going to be different. Okay, babies, let's see what we need for today's job. We're going to need, obviously, we're going to need a new faucet, a rag. This is just an old t-shirt I cut. Pliers. Channel locks is preferable. Things you might need would include silicone, plumber's putty, tape for marking something, thread tape, Teflon tape. Always have a razor blade on deck. Always have both kinds of screwdrivers. Your hair also may be getting crazy, so you may have to use a chip clip on it halfway through the episode. Who knows what's going to happen to you. Okay, welcome to the upstairs bathroom at the Simsy Fixie Mansion. This is what we're going to do. We're going to replace this faucet here. It's generally pretty crappy. Never really worked that well to begin with. You know, I want to show you guys the process of how it works to replace one of these entirely. So hopefully you'll feel empowered and encouraged by the end of this little demo. First thing you need to do, if you're shooting a TV show, you gotta take the mirror down. Second thing we're gonna need to do is we're gonna remove all of these skincare products. These are your partner's skincare products, and ostensibly, I believe they are probably pretty expensive and precious. Now partners, we get to use these every now and then as a treat. But this is not an everyday occurrence, okay? So we have to treat these with reverence, with respect, and with the utmost amount of kindness to them. So we're going to remove these so we don't get lambasted. The tile in this bathroom is probably 50 years old or something, and it feels like they put it on with, like, construction adhesive or glue, or someone tried to fix it with just throwing brown liquid all over it. So it's kind of gross, but I'm telling you right now, it's clean. I cleaned it, but we're gonna wait until Simsy Fixie gets officially signed in to the HGTV network before we're gonna replace all the tile in here, because I'm not paying for it. HGTV, 7/8 Central Simsy Fixie program, they're gonna be paying for this and we're gonna watch. It's gonna be amazing. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna turn off the supply. This is the water supply to your faucet. Open the tap, see if anything else is in there. Then you're gonna remove these from the supply line. So just be gentle as you're removing these things. Now's a good time to bring out your little bucket if you need it, because there might be a little bit of water left in here. Your rag, your channel locks. Here we go. Okay, there goes one. What's next is the supply line as it connects to the mixing valves. Take each one of those off. I'm not gonna be able to show you that because the camera angle, but I might try. We might try anyway. Let's see how this works. Oh yeah, look at that. Gonzo. Gonna get water all over my camera. Probably need to get a TV show after this. If you start doing this and you're like, I fucking hate this, you're not alone. Everybody fucking hates it, but it's gonna be worth it. It only takes like 10, 15 minutes. Now I'm gonna remove each one of these two valves. The supply lines are removed. Everything that secures the valves in is removed. This should just pop right up. Now, what's going to be left is going to just put you in an absolute state of dismay. Don't worry about it. We're going to use our razor blade and our rag. We're going to clean that right up. First, we're going to remove this thing. This is a drain section that doesn't work. So how we're going to do that? Start at the P-trap. Start right here at the back. Unscrews. This is going to smell horrendous, you guys. Okay, now we're going to remove this nut around this drain. Boom, there it is. Look at that. Ish. All we really have now is sort of an empty sink. This is a good thing for you guys to see. Totally naked. All right, we're going to put it back together. Make sure this is not so stinky. All right, you guys. Now we're going to start with the drain assembly. This nut came on the bottom. I just took it off real quick so you can see. This very, very fancy thing here. This, we're going to use a little thing called plumber's putty. A little bead of it around. Take a little bit. Make a snake. Lay it in there. You don't need a drastic amount. Now, we just slide this fella right down in there. Ask your daddy. From the bottom, up comes this little other piece of rubber guy that came with it. I don't know if you can see that very well. And then this fella here. And then you just screw that on clockwise. Now again, we want to be conscientious about over-tightening. We don't want to do that because it's all plastic parts. You know, all you Hulks and She-Hulks out there don't have to be blasting on it too hard. Now let's just put our little drain assembly back in. All right, so we did the hard part. The easy part is just putting this little plate down. This has a compression fitting on it, so you don't need silicone on this one. So that goes in, then these guys go in underneath. Right there. Okay, let's test it out. Cold works. Hot's working. That's it, easy enough. Another episode down. Episode 4, Simsy Fixie program. You guys are the absolute best. Shout out to the Simsy Fixie Hive out there. Keep doing your thing, all three of you. Keep making your spaces beautiful. Keep making your lives as beautiful as possible. Times are very insanely difficult right now. We're doing our best, and let's just continue to do our best. Fix all the crap around your apartment that your landlord would not dare do. It's not up to them if your space looks awesome. It's up to you.
Simsy Fixie.
That is Mike.
Dapper?
That's Mike.
That is Mike McLaughlin. Wow.
Wow, that's pretty good.
That is incredible. I got that instantly. Well done.
That's really good.
Really, really good.
A turtleneck.
Yep.
Which is great.
One of Mike's classic turtlenecks.
Gold teeth.
Yep, got the teeth. Got the tattoo.
Kind of vacant stare in his eyes.
Yep.
It's really good, actually. Way to go, kid.
This is great.
I don't know. Album cover.
Yeah, album cover.
You know.
Mike McLaughlin, who will be he'll be a host on here in the next couple episodes, and he'll be able to fill you in on all the new music he's working on. But this is good. This is a nice little teaser. This might be how we roll out the promo campaign.
Yeah.
Slowly.
I think it's already started.
New demographic.
Well done. This is so great.
Really good. Nice.
Showering.
Oh, that's right.
Don't
worry about that. Just
keep talking like that. There's gonna be an accident.
Uh-oh. Accident. How did that get all the way in there? My bad.
When I get to sleep, I'm the king of the Cuban thing. Whoops. Do you guys wanna do it together? Or do you wanna do it together?
I'm DJ Fundo, and you're watching Doomtree TV.
Hi, welcome to another episode of Broke Ass Kitchen, starring me. I'm not going crazy, you are. Oh, I'm rolling? Oh, so in tough times like these, you still want a little sweetness, right? Right here in your tum-tum. You know me, I like it sweet. So today, let's make some Jell-O. Oh, hi guys. Showing off a little bit? Mm-hmm. Well, here's how I'm gonna make Jell-O today. Okay, step one.
Jell-O.
Squeeze it in.
Yes, get out of there. Get out of there. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah, just like that. Yeah.
And there you have it, folks. Jell-O. Thanks for joining me. See you next week.
Back in the day when I was young, I'm not a kid anymore, but some days I sit and wish I was a kid again. Back in the day.
Die for a big fan of life and humble.
Big fan of lights and tunnels. So sick, man. Got so sick, man. Quick, man. Goddamn, someone better get me.
Whoa, whoa. Here we go again. It's always on 10. It's always on 10. Here we go again, again. It's always on 10. It's always on 10.
Tumblers catching quick, and then turn here.
three.
Welcome back to the outro section of Doomtree TV episode 5 with Paper Tiger, Cecil Otter, and myself, Laserbeak.
Well, that was a great episode. That was a great episode.
By far the best one yet.
Yeah. We
still drying the piers.
Yeah. Some tears, some laughs. We all learned something.
A roller coaster of emotions. For those of you that are unfamiliar, Doomtree TV is free for the people. But we do have the Patreon going, maybe in this corner, maybe in that corner. Patreon.com/Doomtree is a new model that we've been using for people to support us and help us to continue to create the art that we so enjoy making and releasing it in a timely manner. And for those that don't know too, like, you know, these episodes are for everybody, but the Patreon members are getting extra clips and check-ins from all the people in Doomtree every month, and a bunch of other cool stuff. So if, I know times are tough, pockets are tight. If you feel like you've got 10 bucks a month to spare, hit that Patreon and support your local rap crew. In the meantime, you know, let's wrap it up with some shout outs. I got to give another huge shout out to just schools and teachers in general, as I'm still learning this online homeschooling thing, but they are like absolute heroes. First responders, all the people working on the front line, anyone fighting for policy, for the little guys, you know, and just like literally every single one of you watching. I just am thankful for community, even in this separation. And I'm trying to find that type of like hope and positivity amongst our people. And I feel like I got a lot of people. So
yeah,
this has been like one amazing distraction to do this TV show every week, but also like, you know, Friday night and we're hopping in the YouTube chat and we're like, it feels like we're all watching a movie together. That makes me so happy. I'm really thankful for that. You guys got anything? Anything you're thankful for? It doesn't have to be heavy. It could be like hot dogs.
I mean, yeah, definitely just thankful for our community and just friends in general. Just like being able to chat with friends, phone calls and Zoom calls and like just little things that like kind of get you through the day. Like I was texting with Cecil and Mike this morning. We're just like going back and forth, like talking about like 80s skateboard shoes and like all that kind of just little things. You're like, oh yeah, I remember these and all that stuff. Like just those are the little things that get me through the day for sure.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah. I would also just like, yeah, very thankful for friends and family. Like I feel like somehow it brought, you know, my family closer together, which is funny. So I'm like really, really, really thankful for that. And obviously like everyone who supports us and things like this just kind of show you something that maybe you don't see, you know, you've been doing it for so long until something like this comes around. You're just like, not like I took it for granted, but maybe just had no idea like how much support there actually is out there. So it's been,
totally. I mean, I think
see unfold.
I feel like I'm in contact with you know, the seven of us are in contact more than we've been in years. Even though we're not like in the same room, whether it's getting the Patreon going or making that Five Alive song or making the show, like it's been a strangely, I don't know, kind of crazy, beautiful thing in the chaos, the eye of the storm or whatever. So,
right.
Well, thanks everyone for watching.
Yeah.
Cheers to all of you. And thanks, Cease and Papes. Have a phenomenal weekend, and we'll see you guys next Friday.
I am a mountain, a sequoia, the impenetrable truth, stoic, immovable.